Welcome to Learn Commerce PU Online Classes. Don't forget to like our video and subscribe our YouTube channel for all the updates.
Hello students, welcome to First PUC Business Studies Online Classes. Myself Dr. Prakash Bhatt. Students, I will take up a new chapter because it is necessary. I have already done with the second PUC both accountancy and business studies classes. So I think it is better to take up one or two chapters so that your syllabus can be completed as early as possible. We never know when the COVID will end and when the regular classes will start. It's a question mark for all, isn't it? Even then, let us try to cover as much topics as possible. So that when the college gets reopened, if syllabus is reduced and if they give the syllabus, then if our syllabus is already done, then we'll be comfortable and we can do revision, right? So for that reason, I have thought of taking up one or two chapters of business studies. Yes, friends, I think it is better to start from third chapter, that is private, public and global enterprises. Private, public and global enterprises. Before moving on to the very topic, private enterprises, public enterprises, global enterprises, these are three separate types of enterprises. We'll take up each one separately. You have studied various forms of business ownership well before this, that is sole proprietorship or sole trading concern or one man show. Then you have studied Hindu undivided families or HUFs or what? Family owned business, isn't it? Hindu undivided families, HUFs. Then you have studied about partnership where more than two people join together, they run the business, isn't it? So here, all these, then you have studied company form of business ownership, that is joint stock companies. As per Companies Act 1956, revised, isn't it, amended with or replaced with the Companies Act 2013. There you have studied all the, that is details like sole proprietorship, one man show. A single person controls the entire business starting from purchase or production, then sale, marketing, collection of cash, isn't it? All the activities are done by one person. Obba eka vyakti samste ಒಬ್ಬನೇ ಆ ವ್ಯಾಪಾರವನ್ನು ನಡೆಸ್ಕೊಂಡು ಹೋಗ್ತಾನೆ, ಎಲ್ಲ ಅದರ ಚಟುವಟಿಕೆಗಳನ್ನು ಒಬ್ಬನೇ ಮಾಡ್ತಾನೆ. ಬಹುಶಃ ನೀವು ನೋಡಿರ್ಬೋದು, ಸಣ್ಣ ಕ್ಯಾಂಟೀನ್ ನೋಡಿರ್ಬೋದು, ಒಬ್ಬನೇ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡ್ತಾನೆ, ಒಂದು ಬೈರಸಿಗೆ ಹಾಕ್ಕೊಳ್ತಾನೆ ಹೆಗಲಲ್ಲಿ ಅಲ್ವಾ. ಪ್ಲೇಟನ್ನು ಆ ಬೈರಸಿಂದ ಬೆಳಿಗ್ಗೆಯಿಂದ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ ಸಂಜೆವರೆಗೆ ಅದರಲ್ಲೇ ಒರೆಸ್ತಾನೆ, ಅವನೇ ಕ್ಲೀನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾನೆ ತಟ್ಟೆಗಳನ್ನು ಅಲ್ವಾ, ಅವನೇ ಕುಕ್, ಬೆಳಿಗ್ಗೆ ಬೇಗ ಬಂದು ಎಲ್ಲ ರೆಡಿ ಮಾಡಿ ಇಟ್ಕೊಂಡಿರ್ತಾನೆ ಕಸ್ಟಮರ್ಸ್ ಬಂದಾಗೆ ಟೀ ಮಾಡಿ ಸರ್ವ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇರ್ತಾನೆ ಅಲ್ವಾ ಅದನ್ನು ಏಕ ವ್ಯಕ್ತಿ ಸಂಸ್ಥೆ ಈ ಒಬ್ಬನೇ ನಡೆಸುವಂತ ವ್ಯಾಪಾರ ಆರ್ ಸೋಲ್ ಟ್ರೇಡಿಂಗ್ ಕನ್ಸರ್ನ್ ಅಂತ ಕರೀತೇವೆ ನಾವು ಆಮೆ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಎಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಸುಮಾರು ಅಡಚಣೆಗಳನ್ನು ನಾವು ನೋಡ್ತೇವೆ ಅನಿಯಮಿತ ಜವಾಬ್ದಾರಿ ಯಾಕಂದ್ರೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಆದಂತಹ ಲಾಭವನ್ನು ಅವನೇ ಅನುಭವಿಸುತ್ತಾನೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಆದ ನಷ್ಟವನ್ನು ಕೂಡ ಅವನೇ ಭರಿಸಬೇಕು ಬೇರೆ ಯಾರು ಇರುವುದಿಲ್ಲ ಒಂದು ವೇಳೆ ವ್ಯಾಪಾರದ ಹಣ ಸಾಕಾಗದಿದ್ರೆ ಅವನು ಏನು ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ತನ್ನ ಆಸ್ತಿಯನ್ನು ಮಾರಿಯಾದರೂ ಆ ವ್ಯಾಪಾರದ ಸಾಲವನ್ನು ತೀರಿಸಬೇಕಾಗುತ್ತದೆ ಸೊ ದ ಲಯಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಎ ಸೋಲ್ ಟ್ರೇಡರ್ ಇಸ್ ಅನ್ಲಿಮಿಟೆಡ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ he is responsible to make good the losses of the business if there is continuous loss he has to close down the shutters of his business or he has to make good the loss even by selling his private car private bungalow or whatever the property he has no one else will bear the losses because he is not sharing the profits with others he enjoys entire profits by himself Am I correct? Yes. So that is the case of sole proprietorship. That is unlimited liability is the major defect of sole trading concern. Then limited capital, not possible to operate on a large scale, huge scale. Even in case of Hindu undivided family or joint Hindu family firm, there you can see all the family members. They participate in the business. The senior most person is called karta or the manager, isn't it? There also you can see the liability of all co-partners or members of joint in the family firm other than the manager, other than karta. The liability of co-partners is unlimited. Is it? No. Liability of co-partners is limited and the liability of karta or the manager is unlimited in case of joint Hindu family firm or Hindu undivided family. Avibhakta kutumba vyaparam nadustara adanta ella kashta nashtagalige javabdariyar honegara yaru alli karta athava manager anta yaranna naavu karitteve avune vyavasthapaka alva avune adannu bharisbeku ಅವನ ಜವಾಬ್ದಾರಿ ಅನಿಯಮಿತವಾಗಿರ್ತದೆ ಮತ್ತು ಬಾಕಿ ಎಲ್ಲ ಅದರ ಸದಸ್ಯರು ಯಾರಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಅವರಿಗೆ ಅಷ್ಟು ಜವಾಬ್ದಾರಿ ಇರುವುದಿಲ್ಲ ಅವರಿಗೆ ಕೇವಲ ಅವರ ಎಷ್ಟು ಪಾಲಿದೆ ಅದನ್ನು ತಗೊಳ್ಳುವಂಥ ಮಾತ್ರ ಅಧಿಕಾರ ಇರ್ತದೆ ಅದಕ್ಕಿಂತ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಅವರು ಕೇಳುವಾಗಿಲ್ಲ ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಕೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಹಿಂದೂ ಅನ್ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಫ್ಯಾಮಿಲಿ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಟೇಕ್ ಅ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ನರ್ಶಿಪ್ ಫರ್ಮ್ ಮಿನಿಮಮ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೆಂಬರ್ಸ್ is 2 in case of partnership firm isn't it here also you can see unlimited liability of partners other than what limited partners but such type of partnerships are not there because no one will take partners as a limited partners all the partners will enjoy the profits if there is a loss all of them should bear in their agreed proportion agreed ratio or equally correct palugarike paludararu en martare uttagi bandavala haki aa dodda mottavannu sangraha martare capital ant karitevu naavu bandavala adrindagi en maarabodu dodda pramanada ondu ವ್ಯಾಪಾರವನ್ನು ಮಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ವ್ಯವಹಾರವನ್ನು ಮಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಸಾಧ್ಯತೆ ಇದೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಕೂಡ ಪ್ರತಿಯೊಬ್ಬ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ನರ್ ಪಾಲುದಾರನ ಜವಾಬ್ದಾರಿ ಅನಿಯಮಿತವಾಗಿರ್ತದೆ ಅನಿಯಮಿತ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ಮಿತಿ ಇಲ್ಲ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಜವಾಬ್ದಾರಿ ತುಂಬ ಇದೆ ಒಂದು ವೇಳೆ ವ್ಯಾಪಾರದಲ್ಲಿ ನಷ್ಟ ಆದರೆ ಅವರ ವೈಯಕ್ತಿಕ ಆಸ್ತಿಯನ್ನು ಮಾರಿಕೊಂಡಾದರೂ ಅವರು ಆ ನಷ್ಟವನ್ನು ಭರಿಸಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ನಿಯಮ ಇದೆ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಕೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ನರ್ಶಿಪ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ವೇರ್ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಅಗೇನ್ unlimited liability of the partners then a new form of business was thought of to operate on a giant scale or large scale huge scale which is called company form of business organization joint stock company form of business organization. Separate act is passed for that, like you have Partnership Act 1932. In the same way, you will have the Joint Stock Company Act, Companies Act of 2013. Earlier it was 1956, now it is 2013, isn't it? So there you can see a different, that is a liability. All the members will have limited liability to the extent of capital contributed by them and not a single paise more. So the liability of each and every member in a joint stock company is limited to the extent of capital contributed by them and not more than that. Andre koodu bandavala samsthe anta helthevu naavu ellaru ottagi saaviraru janaru lakshagatle janaru tammallida sanna sanna mottavannu sharena roopadalli sharealli viniyoga maadikondo aa ella aa sharena mottavannu ottu maadidaga brahat gaatrada ondu ಬಂಡವಾಳ ಒಟ್ಟಾಗ್ತದೆ. ಅದರಿಂದ ಬೃಹತ್ ಗಾತ್ರದ ಒಂದು ವ್ಯಾಪಾರ ವ್ಯವಹಾರ ಸಂಸ್ಥೆಯನ್ನು ನಡೆಸಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಸಾಧ್ಯ ಆಗ್ತದೆ. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ಪ್ರತಿಯೊಬ್ಬ ಸದಸ್ಯನ ಜವಾಬ್ದಾರಿ ಅವನು ಎಷ್ಟು ಷೇರನ್ನು ತಗೊಳ್ತಾನೆ ಅಷ್ಟು ಮಾತ್ರ. ನಾನೀಗ ಸಪೋಸ್ 10,000 ಷೇರನ್ನು ಬೈ ಮಾಡಿದೆ ರಿಲಯನ್ಸ್ ಇಂಡಸ್ಟ್ರೀಸ್ ಲಿಮಿಟೆಡ್. ನನ್ನ ಜವಾಬ್ದಾರಿ ಆ 10,000 ಷೇರಿನ ಮೇಲೆ ಎಷ್ಟು ಹಣ ಕೊಡಬೇಕು ಕಂಪನಿಗೆ ಅಷ್ಟು ಮಾತ್ರ ನನ್ನ ಜವಾಬ್ದಾರಿ. ಅದಕ್ಕಿಂತ ಒಂದು ಪೈಸೆ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಅವರು ಕೇಳುವಾಗಿಲ್ಲ, ನಾನು ಕೊಡಬೇಕಂತಲೂ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಲಿಮಿಟೆಡ್ ಲಯಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಮೆಂಬರ್ಸ್, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ದ ಲಯಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಈಚ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಎವ್ರಿ ಮೆಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಎ ಜಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಸ್ಟಾಕ್ ಕಂಪನಿ ಈಸ್ ಲಿಮಿಟೆಡ್ ಟು ದ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಕಾಂಟ್ರಿಬ್ಯೂಟೆಡ್ ಬೈ ದೆಮ್ ಅಂಡ್ ನಾಟ್ ಅ ಸಿಂಗಲ್ ಪೈಸೆ ಮೋರ್. ಇಫ್ ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಹ್ಯೂಜ್ ಲಾಸಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಕಂಪನಿ ದೇ ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಎಲಿಜಿಬಲ್, ದ ಕಂಪನಿ ಕೆನಾಟ್ ಡಿಮಾಂಡ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಕೆನಾಟ್ ಡಿಮಾಂಡ್ money from the shareholders. They can demand up to the shares that is subscribed by the members and not more than that. As I already told you, if I have purchased 10,000 shares, my liability is to pay the amount of 10,000 shares only and not more than that. Even after that there are losses, then I will not be responsible for that. So this is what the limited liability of members through which joint stock company runs. And there are two types of companies we have seen, public company and private company, correct? Minimum number of members in a private company is 2. Minimum number of members in a public limited company is 7, correct? Maximum public limited, no limit, unlimited. In private company, how much? 200. Correct. So that is what the number of members and the liability of the members in a joint stock company. Now I am moving on to a new type of this forms, a new form of business ownership, that is private, public and global enterprises. How we can start business? I want to start a business, maybe restaurant business or manufacturing business, manufacturing sugar or manufacturing jaggery or manufacturing cement, isn't it? Anything for that matter, maybe synthetic processing, isn't it? Analytical assembly line industry, anything I can take up. Yaavude vyavaharon maadabodu alva, adu bekadre naavu tokkondu maaruvantadu irli athava naavu utpadane maadi ಮಾರುವಂಥದ್ದಿರಲಿ, ಯಾವ ರೀತಿಯ ವ್ಯವಹಾರ ಆದರೂ ಕೂಡ ನಾವು ವ್ಯವಹಾರ ಮಾಡಲೇಬೇಕು. ಸೊ ವೆನ್ ವಿ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಅ ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್, ವಿ ಮಸ್ಟ್ ಥಿಂಕ್ ಆಫ್ ಹೌ ಟು ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಎ ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ವಾಟ್ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ಅವರ್ ಸ್ಕೇಲ್, ಹೌ ಮಚ್ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್. ಡಿಪೆಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಅಪಾನ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಥಿಂಕ್ ಆಫ್ ಸ್ಕೇಲ್, ಇಸ್ಟ್ ಇಟ್? ಇಫ್ ಯು ಡೋಂಟ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ 1 rupee ಇನ್ ಯುವರ್ ಪಾಕೆಟ್ ಆರ್ ಮೇ ಬಿ 10 rupees ಇನ್ ಯುವರ್ ಪಾಕೆಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಥಿಂಕ್ ಆಫ್ ಈಟಿಂಗ್ ಐಸ್ ಕ್ರೀಮ್ ಮೇ ಬಿ ಗಡ್ಬಡ್ ಆರ್ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್, is it possible? No, it is not possible, right? If when you have 10 rupees in your pocket, you have to think of only chocolate, it's not more, nothing else other than that. Or you have to think of, that is chips, big packet with the full of gas and 2 or 3 chips inside, isn't it? You have to think of that only, because your pocket is not permitting. In the same way, when you start a business, you must think about the capital you have in your hand, the business you are going to start, and what is the product you are going to manufacture, whether there is demand in the market, isn't it? That should also be there. Whether raw material is available, kaccha vastu siktada, siddha vastu adanantara adike bedike unta, ಎಷ್ಟು ಹಣ ಇದೆ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಹತ್ರ, ಅದನ್ನು ತಯಾರಿಸಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಬೇಕಾದಂತಹ ಮೆಷಿನರಿ, ಇದನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ಯಂತ್ರೋಪಕರಣಗಳಾಗಲಿ ಅಥವಾ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಬೇಕಾದಂತಹ ಕಚ್ಚಾ ವಸ್ತು ಆಗಲಿ, ಎಲ್ಲವನ್ನು ತಗೊಳ್ಳಿಕ್ಕೆ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಹತ್ರ ಬೇಕಾದಷ್ಟು ಹಣ ಉಂಟ? ಯಾವ ಗಾತ್ರದಲ್ಲಿ ನೀವು ಹೋಗ್ತೀರಿ? ದೊಡ್ಡ ಪ್ರಮಾಣದಲ್ಲಿ ಹೋಗ್ತೀರಾ ಅಥವಾ ಸಣ್ಣ ಪ್ರಮಾಣದಲ್ಲಿ ನೀವು ವ್ಯಾಪಾರವನ್ನು ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಾ, ವ್ಯವಹಾರ ನಡೆಸ್ತೀರಾ? ಇದೆಲ್ಲ ಲೆಕ್ಕಕ್ಕೆ ಬರ್ತದೆ. ಬೈ ಕೀಪಿಂಗ್ ಆಲ್ ದೀಸ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಮೈಂಡ್, ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಥಿಂಕ್ which type of, which form of business ownership is suitable for us, and on the basis of that you have to prepare your strategies. That is what the introduction part of this chapter is. Now I am moving on to this chapter, that is private, public and global enterprises, where when we start a business, our economy, let us take our economy, that is Indian economy. Indian economy, it is a mixed economy, friends. It is a mixed economy where we are not seeing entirely government enterprises, we are not seeing entirely private enterprises, but there are private and public enterprises. Private and public enterprises. There are two types of enterprises in India. So it is called mixed economy. In some cases, we have private and public both partnership. A part of share will be that is contributed by the private, and the remaining part will be contributed by the government. So such type of business ownerships are there in India. So that is a private and public. Private and public. Under private, you have already studied a lot of different forms of ownership, as I already explained, like sole proprietorship. Under this, we have studied sole proprietorship or sole trading concern. Hindu undivided families or joint Hindu family firm, partnership firm, company form of business organization, isn't it? Under company form of business organization, you have come across two types, that is private limited companies and public limited companies. Private limited companies, no doubt, purely it is companies, the capital is contributed by the directors themselves, isn't it? Public limited company, where there is a chance for the others, the public, general public, to invest in the company, they can buy the shares. Private limited companies, they never issue shares to outsiders. But public limited companies, they issue the shares to the public and they collect money from the public. Koodu bandavala samsthe bagge helta idden nanu. Alli eradu reetiya company galive. Ondu kevala yaru nirdeshakaru yaridare, directors, avare hana hakikondu adannu nadustare. Sarvajanikarige, sarvajanikarinda share vantigeyannu avaru padiyudilla. ಆದ್ದರಿಂದ ಏನು ಹಣ ಅವರು ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ, ವ್ಯಾಪಾರ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ, ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಬೇಕಾದಂತ ಹಣವನ್ನು ಅವರೇ ತಯಾರು ಮಾಡಿ ಒಟ್ಟು ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಯಾರು? ನಿರ್ದೇಶಕರು. ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಪಬ್ಲಿಕ್ ಲಿಮಿಟೆಡ್ ಕಂಪನಿ, ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ, ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಹಣವನ್ನು ಅವರೇ ಹಾಕ್ತಾರೆ ನಿರ್ದೇಶಕರು. ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಮಿನಿಮಮ್ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಕ್ರಿಪ್ಷನ್, ಇಸ್ಂಟ್ ಇಟ್? ನಾಟ್ ಮಿನಿಮಮ್ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಕ್ರಿಪ್ಷನ್, ಐ ಆಮ್ ಸಾರಿ, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟರ್ಸ್, ದೇ ಕಾಂಟ್ರಿಬ್ಯೂಟ್, ದೇ ವಿಲ್ ಗಿವ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಸಿಗ್ನೇಟರೀಸ್ ಟು ಮೆಮೊರಾಂಡಮ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಸೋಸಿಯೇಷನ್ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ ನಾವು ಅವ್ರನ್ನು. ಅವ್ರೇನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ, ಅವರು ಹಣ ಹಾಕ್ತಾರೆ, ಆಮೇಲೆ ಉಳಿದ ಬಂಡವಾಳವನ್ನು ಸಾರ್ವಜನಿಕರಿಂದ ಷೇರನ್ನು ಇಶ್ಯೂ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಂಡು ತಗೊಳ್ತಾರೆ. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ವೇ ಹೌ ದ ಜಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಸ್ಟಾಕ್ ಕಂಪನೀಸ್ ರನ್. ಆಲ್ ದೀಸ್ ಕಮ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡರ್ ಪ್ರೈವೇಟ್ ಸೆಕ್ಟರ್, ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ಸ್. ದೇ ಆರ್ ಆಲ್ ಪ್ರೈವೇಟ್ ಸೆಕ್ಟರ್ ಎಂಟರ್ಪ್ರೈಸಸ್. ನೌ ಮೂವಿಂಗ್ ಆನ್ ಟು ದ ಅದರ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ if we take up, that is public enterprises or government undertakings. Government undertakings or public enterprises, we can say that public enterprises. Illi innondu form ide private alli, company form of business ownership aadmele ಯಾವುದು ಮಲ್ಟಿನ್ಯಾಷನಲ್ ಕಂಪನೀಸ್ ಅಂತ ಹೊಸತ್ತು ನ್ಯೂ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಆಫ್ ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ ಓನರ್ಶಿಪ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟೆಡ್ ರೀಸೆಂಟ್ಲಿ ಇಸ್ಂಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ದೇರ್ ಬಿಫೋರ್ 1990s ಆರ್ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದಟ್ That is Industrial Policy Resolution Act 1948-1956. There was more, that is a demand for public enterprises to establish. Later, that is during Vajpayee government, wasn't it? Manmohan Singh, then Vajpayee government. During that time, it took momentum that public enterprises are like, that is white elephants. ಬಿಳಿ ಆನೆ ಐರಾವತ ದೇವೇಂದ್ರನ ಆನೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ ನೋಡಿದ್ದೀರಾ ಯಾರಾದರೂ ವೈಟ್ ಎಲಿಫೆಂಟನ್ನು ಇಲ್ಲ ದೇವೇಂದ್ರನ ನೋಡಿದ್ದೀರಾ ಇಲ್ಲ ಅವನ ಐರಾವತವನ್ನು ನೋಡಿದ್ದೀರಾ ಇಲ್ಲ ಐರಾವತ ನೋಡ್ತೇವೆ ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಸರ್ಕಾರಿ ಬಸ್ಗಳು ಐರಾವತ ಅದನ್ನು ನೋಡಿದ್ದೇವೆ ವೈಟ್ ಬಸ್ಸಸ್ ಇಸ್ಂಟ್ ಇಟ್ ನಾಟ್ ದ ಎಲಿಫೆಂಟ್ ಸೊ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಡ್ರ್ಯಾಗ್ ಆನ್ ದ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಗವರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಚೆಕರ್ ಸರ್ಕಾರದ ಟ್ರೆಜರಿ ಏನಿದೆ ಅದರ ಮೇಲೆ ಇದು ಹೊರೆ ಯಾಕಂದ್ರೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಕರಪ್ಷನ್ ರೆಡ್ ಟ್ಯಾಪಿಸಮ್ ಎವ್ರಿಥಿಂಗ್ ಇಸ್ ದೇರ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಯಾರ್ಯಾರು ಹಣ ತಿಂದು ಹಣ ಪೋಲಾಗಿ ಹೋಗ್ತದೆ ಬೇಕಾದ್ದಾಗೋದಿಲ್ಲ ಉತ್ಪಾದನೆ ಆದರೂ ಕೂಡ ಗುಣಮಟ್ಟದ ಉತ್ಪಾದನೆ ಆಗೋದಿಲ್ಲ ಮಾರಾಟ ಆಗೋದಿಲ್ಲ ಅದು ಅಥವಾ ಯಾರ್ಯಾರು ತಿಂದು ಹೋಗ್ತಾರೆ ಹಣವನ್ನು ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಕೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಪಬ್ಲಿಕ್ ಎಂಟರ್ಪ್ರೈಸಸ್ ಸೊ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ 1990s There was a strong, that is a demand for liberalization, privatization and globalization. That is LPG. Liberalization, liberalization, privatization and globalization. Not your gas cylinder, LPG. Clear? So, ee reetiya ondu concept annu 1990 ralli prarambha madidru. That is liberalization means removing all unwanted restrictions wanted restrictions will be there friends we are not removing all the restrictions I am saying unwanted restrictions will be removed so that there will be free flow of goods and services from one country to another country we will treat the entire world as a global village ಒಂದು ಸಣ್ಣ ಹಳ್ಳಿ ಹಾಗೆ ನಾವು ಇಡೀ ಜಗತ್ತನ್ನು ನೋಡ್ತೇವೆ ಏನಾಗ್ತದೆ ಕೇವಲ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಪೋರ್ಟೇಷನ್ ಕಾಸ್ಟ್ ಬಿಟ್ಟರೆ ಬೇರೆ ಯಾವುದೇ ವ್ಯತ್ಯಾಸ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಬರುವುದಿಲ್ಲ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಎಲ್ಲ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ಗಳು ಎಲ್ಲ ಪ್ರಪಂಚದ ಎಲ್ಲ ಮೂಲೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ನಿಮಗೆ ಸಿಗ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ ಸೊ ಅಂತ ಒಂದು ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟನ್ನು ಥಿಂಕ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರು ಅದನ್ನು ಇಂಟ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಕೂಡ ಮಾಡಿದರು ದೆನ್ ವಿ ಡಿಡ್ ಅ ಲಾಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಇಂಟರ್ನ್ಯಾಷನಲ್ ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ದಿಸ್ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಸ್ಟಡಿ ಲೇಟರ್ ಇನ್ ಇಂಟರ್ನ್ಯಾಷನಲ್ ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಚಾಪ್ಟರ್ ಪ್ರೈವೇಟೈಸೇಷನ್ I already told you just now, white elephants, public enterprises, they have been shifted into the hands of the private owners like Department of Telecommunications was there earlier, Department of Telecommunication. It was shifted and it was converted as a government company, Bharat Sanchar Nigam Limited, Bharat Sanchar Nigam Limited, BSNL, isn't it? Like KEB was there, Karnataka Electricity Board, government undertaking. It has been converted as MESCOM, BESCOM, SESCOM, whatever it is, whatever the name you call, isn't it? MESCOM, Bangalore Electricity Supply Company, Bangalore Electricity Supply Company, like that. It has been divided and companies have been formed, isn't it? So yeah, my point here is private, public and global enterprises here. Private enterprises we have already tackled. Now, global and public enterprise. Under that, there were three types of enterprises. Let me write those enterprises, public enterprises. First one is departmental undertaking. Departmental undertaking. Undertaking. Public corporations. Public corporations. And government companies. These are the three types of public enterprises. They will ask you 4 marks question on this. you will not get 8 marks question on this chapter. You will get only 4 marks question and 1 or 2 marks that is questions you will get. Okay. So let me take up one by one these things, but remember all these are public enterprises. Public enterprises, all these are private enterprises. What are those? Private enterprises are sole trading concern, partnership firm, joint stock company, Hindu undivided families, one more is multinational companies. These are all coming under the private sector enterprises. They may ask you, give an example for a private sector enterprise. Give one form of private sector enterprises, isn't it? Right? Sole trading concern, partnership firm, whatever the name I have already called, quoted, right? Yes. Now, moving on to this now, that is public enterprises. Public enterprises are the industrial, commercial enterprises which are formed and established by the government. They are formed by the government, maybe completely owned by a ministry or established under a special act or formed as the government companies where the majority holdings will be with the government. So these are three forms of public sector enterprises. They may ask you, give one form of public enterprise, departmental undertaking, public corporation, government companies, anything you can write. Okay. So understood now? So it is fully owned by the government where it is established for the welfare of the mass. Public enterprises are established to provide service to the public at large. Sarvajanikarige sahaya madbeku. Sarvajanikarige olleya quality goods athava saraku athava seveyannu odagisbeku annuvanta uddeshadinda sthapane madidanta ee samsthegalannu naavu sarvajanika uddimigalu public enterprises anta kariteve. Idara hindina uddesha janrige tondare aagabardu. ಯಾಕಂದರೆ ಈ ಪ್ರೈವೇಟ್ ಎಂಟರ್ಪ್ರೈಸಸ್ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿದೆ, ಖಾಸಗಿ ಸಂಸ್ಥೆಗಳು ಅವು ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತವೆ, ಸಾರ್ವಜನಿಕರಿಂದ ಎಷ್ಟು ಲೂಟಿ ಮಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಸಾಧ್ಯ ಆಗ್ತದೆ ಅಷ್ಟನ್ನು ಲೂಟಿ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಡುತ್ತವೆ. ಮೊನೋಪೊಲಿ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೇವೆ ನಾವು. ಅಂದರೆ ಕೇವಲ ಒಬ್ಬನೇ ಇದ್ದರೆ, ಒಬ್ಬನ ಹತ್ರ ಮಾತ್ರ ಒಂದು ವಸ್ತಿದೆ, ಏನಾಗ್ತದೆ, ಎಲ್ರಿಗೆ ಬೇಕದು. ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾನೆ ಅವನು, ಸಾಧ್ಯವಾದಷ್ಟು ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಬೆಲೆಗೆ ಮಾರ್ತಾನೆ. ನೀವು ನೋಡಿರ್ಬೋದು ತರಕಾರಿ ಮಾರ್ಕೆಟಿಗೆ ಹೋದಾಗ ಅಲ್ವಾ, ಒಂದೇ ಕಡೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಟೊಮೆಟೊ ಇದ್ರೆ ಬೇರೆ ಯಾರ ಹತ್ರ ಇಲ್ಲ, ಟೊಮೆಟೊ ಎಲ್ಲ ಖಾಲಿಯಾಗಿದೆ. ಎಂತ ಮಾಡ್ತಾನೆ ಅವನು, 40 ಇದ್ದದನ್ನು 80 ಮಾರ್ತಾನೆ ಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ಅಲ್ವಾ. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ಸ್, ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲಾಯಿಟೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಪಬ್ಲಿಕ್, ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲಾಯಿಟೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಪೀಪಲ್ ವಿಲ್ ಟೇಕ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಶುಡ್ ನಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್, ದಿಸ್ ಶುಡ್ ನಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್, ಇಸ್ಂಟ್ ಇಟ್? ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಕೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಪ್ರೈವೇಟ್ ಸೆಕ್ಟರ್ ಎಂಟರ್ಪ್ರೈಸಸ್, ಟು ರಿಮೂವ್ ದೋಸ್ ವೀಕ್ನೆಸ್ಸಸ್ ಆರ್ ಟು stop these exploitation by these private enterprises. Public sector enterprises have been established. First one is to avoid competition. There was competition, and if there is some sort of competition, then what happens if government starts, that is, competing with the private enterprises? What happens ultimately? The private enterprises, they will reduce the prices of the products. Sarkara kadime rate alli kodta untu ration angadi, isn't it? ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಧರ್ಮಕ್ಕೆ ಸಿಗ್ತದೆ, ಅದರಿಂದಾಗಿ ನಮಗೆ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಆಗುದು, ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡುವಂತ ಕಾಣುವುದಿಲ್ಲ. ಬೇಕಾದಷ್ಟು ಅಕ್ಕಿ ಸಿಗ್ತದೆ, ಬೇಕಾದಷ್ಟು ಎಲ್ಲ ಸಿಗುವಾಗ ಯಾಕೆ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು? ಧರ್ಮಕ್ಕೆ ಯಾರಾದರೂ ಕೊಡ್ತಾರೆ ಅಂದರೆ ನಾವು ಯಾಕೆ ಕಷ್ಟಪಡಬೇಕು ಅಲ್ವಾ? ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಟೆಂಡೆನ್ಸಿ. ಸೊ ಬಟ್ ಕಮಿಂಗ್ ಟು ದಿಸ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಹಿಯರ್, ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ವೆನ್ ದರ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಂಪಿಟೀಷನ್ ಅಮಂಗ್ ಪ್ರೈವೇಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಪಬ್ಲಿಕ್ ಸೆಕ್ಟರ್, ದೆನ್ ವಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ಸ್, ದ ಪ್ರೈವೇಟ್ ಸೆಕ್ಟರ್ ದೇ ವಿಲ್ ಟ್ರೈ ಟು ಆಫರ್ ದ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಸರ್ವಿಸಸ್ at cheaper price, cheaper rate, and the quality will be best quality. So always everyone expects best quality at cheaper rate. Am I correct? So that is what the intention was. Because of this intention, with this intention, these forms of business ownership have been established. They are called public sector enterprises. So now the meaning of public sector enterprises is very clear, right? they are the enterprises which are owned and established by the government for the welfare of the people, welfare of the people. Examples: department undertaking, public corporation, government companies. Clear? Now I will move on to the first one, that is departmental undertaking. What is departmental undertaking? Let us take up that. Departmental undertaking. These are the forms of public enterprises which are established by the government under a ministry. It may be the central government or the state government. Remember, these are the enterprises, public enterprises which are established by the government, either state government or central government, under a separate ministry. And the minister in charge of that department will be the head of that undertaking. I'll give best example: railway, post and telegraph. Telegraph is gone now, it is no more, isn't it? Railway, postal department, defense, these are all coming under the direct control of the government, and it is established under a separate ministry. All the work related to that is postal department will be under the control of the postal authorities, isn't it? Postal department of, that is a post, this ministry will be there for that. And railway, under the railway minister, correct, separate minister will be there, and the minister will be responsible for the, that is a working of these enterprises. Even defense, isn't it, under the command of, that is a chief marshal, whatever it is, isn't it, whatever you call the superior person, the person who is the in charge of defense minister will be responsible for the, that is a defense activities in the country. So these are the undertakings which are established under a special ministry, and the employees of government, that is undertaking, departmental undertaking, they are civil servants. They are called civil servants because their salary is paid by the government, maybe state government or central government, it will be paid by the government. And the revenue collected by these departments, these undertakings, will be deposited directly into government treasury. So that is the speciality of departmental undertakings. Understood the meaning of departmental undertaking? It is a form of public sector enterprise which is established under a separate ministry, and the income generated will be deposited into government treasury, and the expenses of these undertakings are done through the budget allocation, isn't it? While doing the budget, the session, during the budget session, while preparing the budget, maybe union budget, the central government budget or the state government budget, during that time a separate amount will be kept apart for the expenses of these departmental undertakings. So that is the speciality of departmental undertaking. Andre ondo department undertaking neravagi idu sarkarada adhinadalli iruttade. Obba mantri adara in charge agiruttane, adara ella aagu hogugalannella aa mantri superior authority agiruttare, avaratra adannu kelabekagutte ellavannu, ಅವರು ಹೇಳಿದ ಹಾಗೆ ಅದನ್ನು ನಡೆಸಿಕೊಂಡು ಹೋಗಬೇಕಾಗ್ತದೆ. ಮತ್ತೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡುವ ಎಂಪ್ಲಾಯೀಸ್ ಯಾರಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಅವರೆಲ್ಲ ಸರ್ಕಾರಿ ಸಿಬ್ಬಂದಿಗಳಾಗಿರ್ತಾರೆ ಸರ್ಕಾರಿ ನೌಕರರಾಗಿರ್ತಾರೆ ಸರ್ಕಾರಿ ನೌಕರರು ಆಮೇಲೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಬಂದ ಏನು ಆದಾಯ ಇದೆ ವಸ್ತುಗಳನ್ನು ಮಾರಿಕೊಂಡು ಈಗ ಪೋಸ್ಟ್ ಆಫೀಸ್ ಇದೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಪ್ ಮಾರ್ತಾರೆ ಅಥವಾ ಬೇರೆ ಏನಾದರೂ ಸ್ಪೀಡ್ ಪೋಸ್ಟ್ ಅಲ್ವಾ ರಿಜಿಸ್ಟರ್ಡ್ ಪೋಸ್ಟ್ ಇದನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಅದರಿಂದ ಬಂದ ಏನು ಆದಾಯ ಇದೆ ಅದೆಲ್ಲ ನೇರವಾಗಿ ಸರ್ಕಾರದ ಖಜಾನೆಗೆ ಹೋಗ್ತದೆ ಸರ್ಕಾರದ ಖಜಾನೆಗೆ ಹೋಗ್ತದೆ ಆಮೇಲೆ ಇವುಗಳಿಗೆ ಬೇಕಾದಂತ ಈ ಸಂಸ್ಥೆಗಳಿಗೆ ಬೇಕಾದಂತ ಖರ್ಚುಗಳನ್ನು ಸರ್ಕಾರದ ಬಜೆಟ್ ಯಾವುದು ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಆಯವ್ಯಯ ಪಟ್ಟಿ ಅದನ್ನು ಮಾಡುವಾಗ ಅದರಿಂದ ಇದಕ್ಕೋಸ್ಕರ ಸೆಪರೇಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಹಣ ತೆಗೆದಿಡ್ತಾರೆ ಸೋ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಡಿಪಾರ್ಟ್ಮೆಂಟಲ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಟೇಕಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ ಎಸ್ ನೌ ಮೂವಿಂಗ್ ಆನ್ ಟು ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಫೀಚರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಡಿಪಾರ್ಟ್ಮೆಂಟಲ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಟೇಕಿಂಗ್ features of departmental undertakings I will take up features of departmental undertaking in the next class features merits and demerits we will take up in the next class okay yes now take down assignment mention any two forms of Mention any two forms of private enterprises. Mention any two forms of private enterprises. Yes, submit your assignment on time. Thank you for watching this video. Thank you.
Don't forget to like our video and subscribe our YouTube channel for all the updates.